In this video, I will show you how to find the angle theta in this triangle, given the length of the two sides of this triangle and the area of this triangle. Now, the question here is, find the angle theta given the area of the below triangle is 24 meters squared. The lengths of the sides are measured in meters. So that means this is 6 meters, this is 8 meters, this is C meters. So basically, we don't know what the value of C is, so this side is unknown. So how do we approach this problem? We have to calculate the angle theta. So immediately, maybe you already see that. Oh, if you know this side, you can use the law of cosine to calculate the angle theta here. Yes, that's true. Let's recall the law of cosine. Law of cosine. And it's saying that C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared minus 2AB times cosine theta. Now, this side is A, this side is B, this side is C, or this side is B, this side is A, doesn't matter. Then we can just calculate what the angle theta is. Now, however, we know what A and B is. We know what A and B's are, but we don't know what the value of C is. So basically here, it's unknown. Then we cannot just isolate the cosine theta and then calculate what the theta is. We have to first find out what the value of C is. So that means you have to first find out the length of C, the base of this triangle. How do you do that? Well, given this information, given the information right now, it may look difficult, but here's what how you should do it. So let's draw a triangle. The same triangle, basically. I draw here just for visualization purpose, but it's the same triangle. Okay, so in this case right now, what I will have to do is, I'm going to call this side A, this side B, this side C. I know that this side is 6, this side is A is given in the question, but right now, I'm going to write this like in a generic form so that I'm going to derive a formula, and then I will substitute back this value in to calculate what C is. Now, this is the triangle. You are giving the value of these two sides, and you have to find out this side, but you don't know what the height is. So what is the height of this triangle? This is the height of the triangle. I will call this h. Usually, if you want to calculate the area of the triangle, you would have to use the formula, right? Half times the base and the height. The height. So in this case, the base is C and the height is h. So let me say h and C. So basically half of the height and the base. And we know that this is equal to 24 as given in the question here, 24 meters square. But we don't know what C is, we don't know what h is, we cannot calculate that. So we're to find out this value here. Well, maybe we don't need to find out h because I said I will find out c as I mentioned before. So how do I find out c? Now, in this case, you don't see a right triangle here. You just see a triangle here. I know the right with the right triangle, you know the Pythagorean theorem. That's really familiar. But of course, in this case, you will actually use the Pythagorean theorem to calculate this problem, to solve this problem, because that's a thing that you might be most familiar with. As you can see here, you already have two right triangle here, and the Pythagorean theorem applies on the right triangle. So I have to label the base differently now because I have two sides here. So in this case, I will move the C a little bit down here, and I will label this side D. Okay, what would be the length of this side? If the whole base here is C and this side is D, then this side must be C minus D. Now, I have relabeled this triangle. Then we can start solving this. Like I mentioned before, you use the Pythagorean theorem. And what does the Pythagorean theorem say? is this side square plus this side square equals to the hypotenuse square. Also, this side square plus this side square is equal to the hypotenuse square. And what's good about this right now is that the height is being shared among these two right triangles. That means you can actually maybe write an equation that can, in terms of h, and then equate them together to solve it. So let's apply the Pythagorean theorem. Let's start on this right triangle. Then this right triangle must be h squared plus c minus d squared equals to a squared, according to the Pythagorean theorem. And how about this one, this right triangle? H squared plus d squared is equal to b squared. Okay. Now, like I said, h here must equal to h here. So let's isolate h, or h squared. That would be good enough. On this side, h squared is equal to a squared minus c minus d squared. And on this side, h squared is equal to b squared minus d squared. Now, x squared must equal to x squared. Then we can say this equals to this. Now I can actually write this now. A squared minus c minus d squared equals to b squared minus d squared. Now, this must be valid. Okay, let's continue from here. We should just expand this. This one square, we can just write that as a squared minus c minus d times c minus d equals to b squared minus d squared. And that's just one term. Alright, of course, let's do this. A squared minus, now this one will be c squared minus 2cd plus d squared. Plus d squared equals to b squared minus d squared. Now the next step I will do is take away the bracket here, then will be a squared minus c squared plus 2cd minus d squared equals to b squared minus d squared. Notice both sides subtract d squared. We can further simplify this to a squared minus c squared plus 2cd equals to b squared. Okay, we can actually utilize this identity later on, or this equation. So, because we know what the area is here, giving the area information, right? So we can always like use the area to figure out what the value of C is. So how do we find the area? Well, we know that it's half hc. So let's rewrite this one. The area of this triangle is half hc. What is h? We can actually use this here, right? We already write h in terms of ac or d. Then we can write this as x squared, this one is equal to a squared minus c minus d squared. Of course, we have to take the square root of both sides to find out what h is. So now this is square root of a squared minus c minus d squared. Then we can actually plug it here. So let me do this. The area is equal to half times h, so basically square root of a squared minus c minus d squared times c, so it has a c here, so this is h. Now the problem here is that's not done, because we don't know what the value of d is. Because in this triangle, like given, you never have the value of D. You're either giving the value of A, B, C, and H, and that's it. So we have to write D in terms of A, B, C, or H. I don't know if we can write anything in terms of H here. But at least we know that. from this equation here, there's a d here, so but we, everything else is just what we would have. Of course, we have to figure out what c is in this case. So let's isolate d here. So in this equation, a squared minus a squared minus c squared plus 2cd is equal to b squared. Now, isolate 2cd and move the a squared minus c squared to the right. So we have 2cd is equal to b squared minus a squared plus c squared. Divide both sides by 2c to isolate d. We have b squared over 2c minus a squared over 2c plus c squared over 2c. I know this c can cancel out, but I will leave it like this for now. Okay. So, actually, this one here, I have already expanded to this form here. So I can write this like this. The area is half a square minus c square plus 2cd minus d square. And of course, don't forget the square root times c. Because once you expand this, this is what it is. Now, I have a d here, so I can substitute this d into this d here, and to substitute here as well. So I have to actually square this one. But squaring this one will be a little bit long, so let me do it on the other side. So I will take this to the other side and square it. So d is equal to b squared over 2c minus a squared over 2c plus c squared over 2c. So d squared is equal to b squared over 2c minus a squared over 2c plus c squared over 2c squared. And that is equal to b squared over 2c minus a squared over 2c plus c squared over 2c times itself, which is b squared over 2c minus a squared over 2c plus c squared over 2c. Now let me distribute this. So d squared is equal to this times this. That is b to the power of 4th over 4c squared, this times this, minus a squared b squared over 4c squared, this times this, plus b squared c squared over 4c squared, minus a squared b squared over 4c squared, this times this, plus a to the 4th over 4c squared, minus a squared c squared over 4c squared. Now I'm going to write in the next line. This times this, plus b squared c squared over 4c squared, this times this, minus a squared c squared over 4c squared, plus c to the 4th over 4c squared. Okay, so let's group the items. We have d squared is equal to, let's take all the power 4th together. B to the 4th over 4c squared plus a to the 4th over 4c squared plus c to the 4th over 4c squared. Okay, now this and this are like terms. So minus 2a squared b squared over 4c squared. This and this are like terms. Plus 2b squared c squared over 4c squared. Then this and this are like terms. So we have minus 2a squared c squared over 4c squared. So this is d squared. Let's come back here. So now I can substitute d into d here. And d squared, I already did it just now. So let's see how this area equation looks like. Half times a squared, I will write the square root later on, minus c squared plus 2c times, this is d, b squared over 2c minus a squared over 2c plus c squared over 2c minus d squared. Now, of course, the square root times c, because I have a c here. Now let's simplify this. As you can see, the 2c here can cancel out with all the 2c at the bottom, and what I have left is area is equal to half. I will write the square root later on. A squared minus c squared plus b squared minus a squared plus c squared minus d squared. And of course, don't forget the square root times c, basically c here. So what do you see here? The c and c will cancel out. The a and a will cancel out. All I have left is just b squared minus d squared under the square root. So the area is half b squared minus d squared, of course, the square root times c, right? So that is the area formula. But I have just calculated d squared like at the top, so I can substitute into this equation here, and I will do it here. Now d squared here, so this is, now let me carry from here, a squared is equal to half the area times b squared minus d squared, of course is under the square root, times c. So I can substitute d squared into d squared here. Okay, so let's see how the area formula will look like now. Half times, I will write the square root later because it's quite long, b to the fourth over 4c squared plus a to the fourth over 4c squared plus c to the fourth over 4c squared minus 2a squared b squared over 4c squared plus 2b squared c squared over 4c squared minus 2a squared c squared over 4c squared. Of course, the square root here, don't forget that, times c. We have a c here still. So that's how it is. But now I am going to take away the bracket and all these sides will flip. So the area is half times, I will write a square root later, b squared minus b to the fourth over 4c squared minus a to the fourth over 4c squared minus c to the fourth over 4c squared plus 2a squared b squared over 4c squared minus 2b squared c squared over 4c squared plus 2a squared c squared over 4c squared. And of course, this whole thing is under the square root. My square root at the back, don't forget times c, because we still have the c here, Now, what you notice here is they all have a common denominator 4c squared. So in order for this to group this together, I have to convert this into a common denominator, which I have to multiply by 4c squared over 4c squared. So this will become 4b squared c squared over 4c squared. Now, look at this expression under the square root. This and this are like term. So we can group this together. So I will become positive 2b squared c squared. Then all this term will be positive and this is negative. So I will write this first and then this. Let me rewrite this area formula. So the area is half times, I will write the square root later because this is a long expression. 2a squared b squared over 4c squared plus 2b squared c squared over 4c squared, because this minus this is positive 2b squared c squared over 4c squared, plus 2a squared c squared over 4c squared minus a to the 4 over 4c squared minus b to the 4 over 4c squared, and of course lastly minus c to the 4th over 4c squared. And of course this whole thing, whole expression is under the square root times c at the back. We still have the c. Now let's look at this, right? The bottom we can always write as one number, 4c squared. Okay, let me rewrite this so that it looks is more visualized. A is equal to half, now we have 2a squared b squared plus 2b squared c squared plus 2a squared c squared minus a to the 4th minus b to the 4th minus c to the 4th, all divided by 4c squared and the square root of all of this times c here. Now we can take a look at this one. What's the square root of 4c squared? It's 2c. Now after the square root you only have 1c here left and cancel out the c here, and what you have left here is a 2. So 1 half times 2 is 1 over 4 times the square root of this. So we have derived a formula for the area of this triangle to be, okay, I will write the 4 at the bottom. So this is 2a squared b squared plus 2b squared c squared plus 2a squared c squared minus a to the 4 minus b to the 4 minus c to the 4th. Of course, the square root of this over 4. Okay, so that is the area formula. That's the formula to calculate the area if you're giving the side length a, b, and c. Now you realize in this equation, everything is just in terms of a, b, and c. Because if anything, in this triangle, you are giving the value of a, b, and c, or h and c. You will never be given the value of d, unless they want to make the question really simple. But here, with this equation that we have, so let me circle it in magenta. With this equation we have, we will be able to calculate the value of c now, because we know the value of b and a and the area. So let's just put it in. From the original question, we know that a is equal to 6 and b is equal to a. We just don't know what c is, but the area is 24 meters squared. That's what is given in the question in the beginning. So let's put that in. So let's put that in to this formula. So a is 24, so 24 equals to 2 times 6 squared times b is a, right? A squared plus 2 times b is a. So a squared, c squared, plus 2 times a, so it's square. So basically 6 squared, c squared. A is 6 to the 4th minus a to the 4 minus c to the 4th. We don't know what c is. Of course, square root of this all divided by 4. Now, let's move the multiply both sides by 4. So we have 24 times 4 on this side equals to, now what's this? Let's calculate the value. So 2 times 6 squared times a squared. So we have 460a. Actually, I can put this a little bit lower now because I'll multiply the 4 on each side. So this is 460a plus, well, a squared is just 64, 2 times 64 is 120a c squared plus 6 times 6, 36 times 2 is 72. C squared. Now minus, well, let's see what that is. 6 to the power of 4 is, well, let's do this. 6 to the power of 4 plus a to the power of 4. So together will be subtract 5392. Let's double check that. Okay, that's right. Now this one just minus c to the 4th. Of course, square root. Now remember, we're trying to solve for c here, right? So c here, of course, to do this we have to square both sides to get rid of the square root on this side. So what's this? 24 times 4 should be 96. Yeah, 96. So basically this is 96 square is equal to, now when you square you only have this inside there, so let's add the terms together. What's 460a? 460a minus 5392, so that's negative 784. But let's do this together first because that is a plus. So let's say this is minus 0.4 minus 7a4. What is this? 128 plus 72, 200 c squared minus c to the 4th minus 784. And what is this? 96 squared. Oh, big number. 9216 is equal to 200 c squared minus c to the 4th minus 784. Now, to solve for C, I think you really have to write into an equation. So let's bring everything to this side. Actually, no. Let's bring everything here to this side. So then I have a positive C to the 4th. So C to the 4th minus 200 C squared. It will be a plus. Maybe I move this one to here. So what is 9216 plus 784? 9216 plus 784. Oh, plus 10,000. And that is equal to 0. So let me double check. Move here. Yes. So now you have an equation to factor to solve for C. That's interesting. So how do we factor this? This is a quadratic equation to the power of 4. But you notice that this looks really similar to a quadratic equation, right? Except it's just to the power of 4 to the power of 2 here. So what if I do this, right? Let k equal to, let me write the k better. Let k equal to c squared. Then what can I say? What can I do here? Well, this one is c squared times c squared minus 200 times c squared plus 10,000 equal to 0. Then I would let k equal to c squared. Then that means what I have now is k squared minus 200k plus 10,000 equal to 0. Now what do you have? A quadratic equation to factor. And now, would that be easy to factor? Yes, it is. Now, how do you factor this? Now think about, like, this is 1, right? Leading coefficient is 1 times this, so we have this, 10,000. What are the two numbers when you multiply together give you 10,000? When you add together give you negative 200. It's negative 100 and negative 100. So then you have a factor form k minus 100 times k minus 100 equal to 0. And what did we say k is equal to? Of course, it's equal to c squared. So we have to put that back in. C squared minus 100 times c squared minus 100 is equal to 0. Okay, so that means this is a perfect square. You can say c squared minus 100 square equal to 0. Then take the square root of both sides to solve for c, right? So c squared minus 100 is equal to 0. Then add 100 to both sides, c squared is equal to 100. Then take the square root of c, then you have square root positive negative 100. Then let me write here, c is equal to positive or negative 10. Now that's a positive or negative value, but don't forget c is the length of this triangle. Can it be a negative value? No, it cannot be. So c must be positive 10. So we have to say that over here, I want to conclude that c is equal to positive 10. So that's the answer. So we have the length of c now. So let's come to this side here. Let me write a triangle again. Let me draw the triangle again. Now we know this size 6, this size a, this size c is 10. So that's what we calculate. Now we have to find this angle theta, right? Using the law of cosine that we mentioned before, this side is a, this side is b, and this side is c. C squared is equal to a squared plus b squared minus 2ab times cosine theta, right? So to isolate cosine theta, we have to, okay, let's take this term to this term and take c squared to this side. Then we have 2ab cosine theta is equal to a squared plus b squared minus c squared. Divide both sides by 2ab to isolate cosine theta. So cosine theta is equal to a squared plus b squared minus c squared over 2ab. So let's plug in all the value that we know, right? We know that, we already know this, a is 6, so 6 squared plus that b is 8, a squared, c is 10, so 10 squared. So let's do this. Cosine of theta is equal to 6 squared plus a squared minus 10 squared over 2 times 6 times a. What is that equal to? This is 36 plus 64 is 100. 100 minus, 10 squared is 100. This is 0. The bottom is 96. Well, 0 over 96 is 0. So cosine of theta is 0. Then what is theta? Well, theta will be equal to cosine inverse 0. If you put in the calculator, right, cosine inverse 0, it gives you 90 degrees. Now let's take a look at it here. Let's look at the triangle. Well, a triangle and also on the Cartesian plane, that's what I mean. So you have this here, and you have a circle. Assuming this is a perfect circle, because I'm just drawing by hand. So this is a unit circle. What that means, the radius is 1. So here, that's the radius, so that's R. Of course, I can extend it down here, and that's angle theta. If this is a unit circle, we know that this side is sine theta, and the bottom here is cosine theta, right? Y-axis and x-axis. Okay, so in this case, right, we said that cosine theta is equal to 0. That's what we have. So when is cosine theta equal to 0? Well, here, basically here. Okay, so at this region, right? So at this time, angle theta is 90 degrees. Because cosine theta would be going this way, and over here will be just 0. You don't have cosine theta. And on this side, right, on the x-axis, cosine theta is not 0. But the next time cosine 0 would be 0 is here, this region here. And from here to here, the angle is basically 90 degrees times 3, 270 degrees. Angle theta. Angle theta. Okay, so you pretty much have only these two answers. So what is the right answer? Now, in a triangle, right? All three angles add up to 180 degrees, and this is a 270 degrees is way too high, right? It cannot be. So the answer must be this, 90 degrees. So the answer to this is angle theta equals 90 degrees in this question. So here, theta here is 90 degrees. Oh, wait a minute. If this angle is 90 degrees, what does it mean? That means this triangle is actually a right triangle. So I can look at it from this side. Right, let's flip the triangle like this. Actually, I mean rotate the triangle. So we know that this side is 6, this side is 8. I just rotated it, and that's angle theta here. So angle theta here. So this side is C. If angle theta is 90 degrees, so this is 90 degree angle, right? Let's validate this using the Pythagorean theorem. What does Pythagorean theorem say? This side square plus this side square equals C square. So we can say that, okay, let's say this side is A, this side is B. So we have to say that 6 square plus A square is equal to C square. 6 square is 36. A square is 64. What's that equal to? That's 100. That's C squared. Take the square root of both sides. Right? C squared square root is equal to 100 square root. Of course, we have to take the positive value because the length of a triangle cannot be negative. Then C is equal to what square root of 110? Oh, nice. C is equal to 10. We get the same answer here. So C is equal to 10 meter because they unit of measure is meter. It's the same as what we get here. C is equal to 10. Now, you see the connection between this? So you see the connection between the Pythagorean theorem and this. And just letting you know that if this formula here, this equation here, if you factor the expression under the square root, you will get to a famous formula, Heron's formula. And that formula. So I just want to describe this Heron's formula. Heron formula. Right, so S is equal to A plus B plus C over 2. And the area of the triangle is the square root of S times S minus A times S minus B times S minus C. So here. So this is a connection between the Heron's formula and the Pythagorean theorem. Hopefully I did not misspell the Pythagorean theorem. Okay, and also, well, this time will be easy. So in reality, right, when you look at this question, to begin with, if you already know there's a right triangle, all you need to do is just like, okay, 6 squared plus 8 squared equals c squared. But of course you don't know that, right? You don't know this is a right triangle. Then you have to actually go through this process to calculate it. So now I said the area is 24 meters square, and I have the length of these two sides. Let's validate this as well, right? So with this, right, the area of the triangle is half, right, the height times the base. Let's call the base B this time, but this base will be here now, and that's the height. So the area is half times A times 6. What is that? Basically 48 divided by 2 is indeed 24. So at the beginning of this question, this is actually a right triangle, and you already know, you pretty much can know the answer right away. But assuming you don't know that, right, what if I'm giving you this? Let's say a triangle. What if the question is this? Oh, let's say this side is 7, this side is 13. Angle theta, and the area is, or the area is 50 meters square. Oh, let's say that, right? So how do you calculate that? So this may not be the right triangle anymore. This angle theta may not be 90 degrees, and you have to find this angle theta. Of course, you have to go through the same process as what I went through just now to calculate that. Okay, so that's it. Hope you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.